asked to be the carry, and I believe that he knows that. He's been doing quite well so far.
Yeah, both teams understand their roles very, very well. Ariel needs to stay protected. She's very wide out in the open, and Beyblade just gets an in-your-face damage onto Ariel, and she still has a high amount of HP left with the DP that she does have innately, but she's not going to stay alive for too long here. The damage coming in very nicely. Can she do the kiting?
He's trying to up against 40s on the Paladin.
Me, what damage?
There you go. That damage is just insane. Obviously, much stronger than Morty's. He's going to die here. And it's rough, too, because when you're spawning one by one, you see AffyDR, he's going to be alive, but eventually he should die, right? And the rest of his teammates come in late, so they are kicked off. Affy is actually going to survive for now. You see that...
very nice.
One of the members...
The version of the points is what they've been doing so well at AffyDR since 23, 22, and 16. DD who's in last place for his team. This is a good role because once again, you're really not putting so much risk on just one single player that, and picking up points like that just makes it so much easier to carry on lifters and really gives no option for the opponents to do anything about it.
A couple of games as obviously the red team here has changed up some of their strategy.
Yeah, and we're going to see if there's kind of any type of miracle that we didn't see from games 1 and 2 with Akabaz's team, but so much damage that's grouping from Zladia and the rest of the boys, and it seems like they know what to do to try to maximize the damage from this AoE range that they have and put in, and collapsing like that with X-Air seem just not going to bring you anything good. You can see that 2 deaths already coming back.
Big kill.
Blue side heavily will believe that this game will be theirs to take, especially with Bayfooty now being chased down by Happy.
Absolutely. They're able to isolate Ortiz.
Look at that though.
They're able to isolate Bayfooty, but he gets away, and a bunch of people caught up there in the corner. I believe that was by Morty. He's able to help and CC them down now. Havoc trying to get it. He gets frozen at
are you
the
serious?
Right time. That is big.
And we're looking at this now. Bayfooty, he's kind of distracted a little bit by Havoc, but still covering that distance to make sure you kite through. And look at that dodge. Just wonderful, wonderful footwork. And that makes Bayfooty such an advantageous player.
Here we do go back into the Ramanas, starting things off here. Always interesting to see, you know, the different strategies that teams do like to play it out. Yeah, the blue team was extremely split up. I mean,
yeah.
Demo is all by himself. Yeah, we were talking about strategy here, and it seems like there's an obvious difference between the two teams and the way they want to pilot this. You just take a look at Demo.
He's just there.
He's there, and it's not like he's AFK or something. He's purposely trying to get orbs and objectives by himself on the side.
Really tough to tell what the strategy is for the Dima's side.
Yeah, it's obvious that they have a very passive play style. I mean, we take another look here at Dima. He's playing the orb game, okay? At least they're catching, or they're at the same amount of orbs, you could say, of the enemy team, even though technically they are behind. Another kill is going to go the way here of Eleutherial.
If the neutral has been the objective for the blue team, are they going to go for this one as well? But you know you just can't camp around to see for the last hit. You're going to have to fight your way through it.
See how this last hit is going to come down. They're trying to zone away Elektra now, just CCing him to death.
Yeah, right around that 3 bar line.
We see Dima looking for that last hit.
He
is going to pick it up, but is it going to matter? The lightning comes in.
Oh, yeah.
And it's going to pick up one kill, make that a little bit more damage onto Civilian. He's on the run.
Well, he was basically on 2 HP when we were starting this interaction altogether, but now at 49 points.
Team, and that is going to bring them over the line as Dima will secure his 49 points.
All right.
That will be enough for them to win the game. A nice point difference for now, but everything can change if that Lagos does go down.
We have 5 health bar at the moment, and it seems like it will go down. And the blue team can steal away. This is going to be a big moment.
It is going to go to the blue team, and now that lightning is going to come out. Everybody on the side of the B team just running away, trying to get to safety. Morty's extremely low, is going to go down.
They should have done a little bit better with protecting Lagos, and they just left it free, and now the blue team is looking like they're going to get the win.
That's all it takes. The slow chip away, it was looking pretty dire. See who is going to pick off that Lagos as it is getting extremely low.
Again.
Who's going to take it this time? And it's going to go the way of Bayfooty's team. As now the lightning is going to come out, and if you're this far ahead and you pick up the Lagos,
that's it.
You're not losing.
That's pretty much it. And the salvation even comes through as just like a
this time around, though, they are going to hold on to their lead as game number two will end with a gigantic lead going the way of the. Can they focus down on Lagos? It's really going
to
be the question.
You can see
the zoning is so good, but Lagos getting pretty low. There's one second. Can they do it? It looks like no.
Oh.
B team will take the. Will we have another nail biter at the end? It looks like we might. Oh,
definitely possible. 10 seconds.
Okay. Got 5-4 left with 8 seconds left. Can
they
burst
it
down? They got it. Now they've got
the lead. They got
they're going to take the lead. Oh, but it's tight
it's
here.
Tight even.
It's tied.
Oh, I think it's going to be a draw.
It's
a
draw.
Man.
Are they going to do it? They're trying to burst it down.
Again.
Kaito X for Dane.
Again.
Is getting in there. And they've got a lot of health, too. They're going to burst
they
it down.
They got it.
They
got it
they
again.
It.
The one point.
Oh,
God,
but it's not enough time. One point, and that's going to do it.
Me some basic numbers right now. 15-0 is the record for the tournament for BBDR Sign at the moment. They haven't lost one, but this is looking like the best of early games that you could expect for BBDR. So gets the salvation right in time. Can he get over to ZDR in time? He does, and this is looking very, very good for a starter Valdez. And 41-23, something that we haven't seen as a deficit for BBDR Sign all tournament long. And maybe this is a little bit of. As we do see some kills coming that way. Three kills.
Yep.
They really don't like it.
I don't know what it is,
they don't allow me to finish the sentences. They really don't.
Yeah, whenever you get excited for this team, they're like, actually, BBDR says hello.